Let's see how to create a virtual table in Power BI. Here we have one data set with data imported from an Excel file. But in case we would like to have just a subset of this data or with some another computed column, how we can do that having a table that do not have its own data. It's just a virtual representation of data from another tables, another data sets. So for this purpose, we are going to use this feature here, the new table functionality that is inside this table view area. When we click in new table button, what happens? As you can see, it has entered here a new table in this part below the real existing table, but this table is a virtual table. It does not exist itself because it's not contains its own data. It's empty. So what we can assign to that? First, the name of the table will change according with the name of the variable we set here. And here in the right side, we can utilize any function from Power BI, from the DAX syntax, that can return a table representation. So in our example, we are going to try this one. This one functionality here, we are going to name the table for as virtual table top sales. In the meaning, we want to represent the top 10 sales from this above table and sorting that in the descendant order. It means the sales that has a bigger value. Okay, so here the sheet one is because it's the name of this table here. And then here we can access one specific field, in this case, field sales. It has not found here exactly the name. Probably there is some syntax here we need to adjust. Probably just click here, a white space. Okay, doing that, you just has to confirm. Now it has processed and take a look here. The original table contains the whole data, 700 entries. And the virtual table contains only 10 entries. Now let's explore how to use that. Now we have a virtual table, we can also utilize that for creating visuals. So if you came here in report view, you can choose any view, like the simple view here, the table view, and then we can relate data from which view could be of our interest, like sheet one or the virtual table. In case we select data from virtual table, we are going to has only 10 entries because it's the total of rows we have in this table. Yes, probably here now we have the 10 entries. In case we have chosen data from this sheet one table, we are going to have the whole data set. We can see difference here in case we use, for instance, this card view. In case we take this card view and here from virtual table select that, and we can say this card view has to show not the sum but the count of entries, it has that 10 entries. And now if we do the same card view but using as source the sales field from the original table and then change here to display the count of entries, we have here the 700. So you can see we have two different sources of data to utilize in visuals, but the original source is the first one. In case we change that, it will automatically change the second one as well. So we can have more than one representation without has duplicated our data. And that's the goal of virtual tables.